Fashion and style is so important to shows like this.
Okay, how much are you loving these outfits?
In a word, it's original.
Some of my favorite shows, they're my favorite shows because when I'm watching them, I'm like, oh my gosh, I love what she's wearing.
I've been so blessed for it to become a character on the show.
All the girls are so different. They each have their own kind of fashion sense.
We're just raising the bar, especially with the second season.
When I first got on the show, I knew what I wanted to do and kind of where I can take this because the pilot was so awesome, but I saw that the clothes had so much potential.
She was clear. She said, I am who I am, and I like to make a statement. I like these girls to be distinctive. I want to know that's an Aria jacket. I want to know those are Spencer shoes. And we've sort of followed her lead.
Aria's so eclectic and one of a kind. She's that girl that you look at and go, what did she put on and how does that look good?
What's cool about Aria is that she really doesn't have one word that describes her style. She's sort of all over the place.
Lucy Hale helps me out a lot, her being her. Sometimes I have to stop myself and be like, okay, Mandi, you have like 6 jackets on her. Because you can do anything with her.
Especially for my character, she'll like take parts of a shirt and add it to another shirt. There's a lot of layering with Aria.
I think it's a lovely metaphor for her as a character because she has to sort of go to school and live her life as a teenager. Her secret life is very adult.
Was there anything else that I need to know?
She wears a lot of stripes. She wears a lot of animal print. And the cool thing is she mixes things that you would never think to put together.
This is one of my favorite things about Lucy. I'll put 5 rings in her room to choose, and all the other girls will be like, I want 2. Aria comes out, doesn't say a word. She got them all on.
Aria pushes the envelope with her accessories, without a doubt. She's always looking for a fashion statement, and she totally utilizes accessories.
I always wear lots of rings on one hand, which is sort of like a Lucy thing, and I sort of incorporated it into Aria's style.
She has to wear armor. Of all our characters, there's a lot of armor she has to wear. Just because of the secret life she lives.
I put soft colors on her sometimes because you look at Lucy and she's just seriously looks like a doll sometimes. I'm drawn to the sweeter colors for her, but I really like blacks and leathers.
I have a personal favorite. It was from the mid-season finale of season 2. And I had this like really cool maxi skirt on. But the thing that stands out to me is it got a lot of attention where I had my hair in a ponytail and I had these like gravity-defying earrings on. They were huge and really geometric. And I had this like cut-up sweater, which is cool. And that's one of my favorite outfits that I would actually wear in real life. I love shoes so much. I don't think she's ever worn a pair twice.
I don't even know how many black boots she has. She can't have enough, because I was like, yeah, but it just needs to be this one. But this needs a buckle, and it needs a little more platform, so I can never find the perfect black boot, which is the same thing in my life, so I think I'm giving her, like, my ADD with boots.
She puts her heart and soul into, you know, every outfit, and especially with Aria, because she says that Aria is like a miniature her, and it's sort of how she dresses in real life.
Aria's black and red striped masquerade dress. We made the fabric, I designed it. It's from head to toe, it's something that I've wanted to do for so long.
We had a specific shoe meeting with Mandi. We're like, Mandi, even though we want the girls to look awesome, they're gonna be running and running and running in these shoes, so please give us something just like a little bit sensible for them. Well, on the day they show up and they get out of their car, and I see them in heels that are about this big. So this was Mandi Line's version of sensible shoe.
It's already so bad, how can it get worse?
I have a personal favorite just because it's so absurd and out there. I look slightly like Beetlejuice, which sounds insane, but I had on these Jeffrey Campbell shoes. They almost look like Lady Gaga would wear them. Believe it or not, I was towering over all the other girls, which is a first for me.
Don't look at me, Hannah's the one trying out. I'm just here to make her look taller.
I think Hannah is the it girl. She's the one that looks through the magazines. There's nothing that she wouldn't do for fashion.
You
didn't know Tori made those boots in brown.
Season 2, Hannah's actually a little bit more sophisticated. She's taking more risks, and she's wearing funky heels or really big jewelry.
Hannah's coming into her own, so this is somebody who's learning how she can actually show off.
She just tries to play everything up and make it such a fashion statement that it was like, where'd she get that?
I made her a little more edgy this season because I think fashion is taking more risks.
One of the characters' funerals in the second season where Hannah wore a, I think, micro mini.
Hannah, it's a funeral, not a Nicki Minaj concert.
So what? I can't dance on his grave? Can I at least throw confetti?
The girls on the show have so many favorite outfits of mine. One of Hannah's is this black and white blazer from H&M, which I got too. And this bright, bright, bright pink, and you can see through it, so I put a really, really short little skirt underneath it. She had heels with no heel.
One of the outfits you'll see was a really, really black long dress. It went shorter in the front and longer in the back with this amazing brown leather jacket and these, like, super tall Sam Edelman heels, like 6 or 7 inches. They were so tall.
Are you asking us to wear these?
The brighter, the better, the softer. She's very drapey. She's sexy. I don't know how much shorter her skirts can get or how much higher her heels can get.
That's like the best part about being Hannah, because she gets to wear the coolest clothes and the cutest dresses and skirts and a lot of high-waisted jeans and blazer and heels.
You can tell a lot about a person by their shoes.
She has really cool jackets this season with scarves, and we've played around with a lot of hats, which I would never really normally wear in my real life. She has amazing earrings. Like, I mean, these are really awesome. She has a lot of big hoop earrings. She has amazing chain necklaces. She likes to stack bracelets.
Anything that, of course, again, says, like, look at me.
Are you satisfied?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm good.
Emily, you started out very sporty. And I think with anyone, you become who you are inside, and I think that really changes in everything.
Emily's fashion sense is constantly changing and transforming as Emily's character changes.
Just being around the other girls, as they become closer, I feel like she's kind of picked items off of each of them and made them work for herself.
This season, her clothes have become more distinctive. She's got a look. She knows what she likes, and she wants to attract a certain kind of person, too.
Okay, are those this season?
There's a lot of boots, a lot of denim, a lot of fun loose tops and, like, sportier tops, off-the-shoulder tops.
She actually looks really pretty in bold colors, but I keep her in grays and blacks now.
She gets a lot of cool accessories. I got a really cool bow and arrow necklace that I really liked, and, like, a lot of the rings we play around with.
Very minimal. She only likes studs, no hoops.
Probably have to say I've gotten to wear some really fun sneakers.
Simple chains, if she does go to like a dance or something. The buckles, the All Saints kind of boots, the military boots. She's got so many boots.
We do work the handbags. We've gotten some really great ones. Rebecca Minkoff is one of my favorite handbag designers. Even our handbags are so different, and they're perfect for each of our characters. So it's really, it's fun.
That's not the right top. You need to turn heads.
My look has changed a lot. When we were first put out, it was very, very young. Spencer was, they quoted her as the all-American girl. Literally, I'm not kidding, every outfit I wore was red, white, and blue.
Well, Spencer comes from a preppy, old money family, so the idea with her is there's always going to be a certain amount of traditional look. But you'll notice in the second season, which we really are enjoying, she's sort of breaking away from her family, and you'll see that in costume.
I put a little hipster vibe on her, too. I keep the conservative. She doesn't do low. She does short, but she always has tights.
Listen, Spencer, decisions had to be made.
She's true to the conservative color palette. Navies, forest greens, brown boots.
So she's very, very constructed, very well put together and classic in all regards, whatever she's doing.
The more cream, the better. She's seriously a hanger.
Mandy is really wonderful at incorporating my own sense of style into Spencer and letting Spencer be kind of influenced by what she sees me in. The fact that I wear vintage riding boots, and she gives those to Spencer. So Spencer's in a lot of
equestrian accoutrement, and there's a very almost Victorian or classical feel about Spencer.
I have a weird animal fetish with her. She always wears little owls or deers, and I don't know why, but this started and I'm going with it.
If you look, like, the prints are always like bird prints, or she has elephant earrings, or like there's a giraffe like bracelet.
She puts a twist on the classic. I think you can take the Ralph Lauren and she'll put some crazy tie on or some like really great vintage belt. And
she's always going for like one thing. It's like she's a sailor today or she's a schoolgirl today.
Hers is preppy classic with a twist.
We did a whole episode where Spencer wore like a full-on denim like cowgirl outfit, and it was so not Spencer, and yet it really was. When we watched the episode, it was like, of course Spencer would wear that. It's like head-to-toe horse gear.
What's a nice way to say someone's obsessive?
Mandy is Mandy. There are no words to describe Mandy. She is hilarious.
I mean, you could build a fence around Mandy and sell tickets. She's the real thing, you know? She's a ride.
She's a visionary. She tells a story with wardrobe in ways that I think most people don't understand. Those stories can be told.
The great thing about Mandy is that she's not dictated by an idea.
The way she builds a wardrobe with the limited resources that she has is intense and amazing.
When the show first started out, and it was under a lot of pressure from our network because they wanted to make the girls very iconic from the beginning. And Mandy, by the time she stepped in, was like, I can make them iconic. That doesn't mean that they have to be wearing the same thing all the time. I know how to hit Spencer while making Spencer more edgy.
I think the look could be high fashion, but I don't think the price necessarily needs to be high fashion. And I think our show is unique in that way that the viewers can really buy what they see.
She has a mind of her own. The things she comes up with is truly amazing, and all the credit goes to her, for sure.
Even when I'm not working, I find myself shopping for them and going, wait a minute, I've got to stop, because it's like this, probably my shopping obsession, and I'm able to take it out on the show.
She is so aware of what's going on in terms of trends and styles.
It's just really cool to know that we have such an influence on, you know, teenagers that watch the show. It's really cute. They send me photos of them at school, and they're like, this is my Hannah-inspired look, and it's something very similar to what I've worn on the show.
Oh, God. I swear I love everything. I get so into it.